Bryan, I just wondered what the draw for you of why him was, and as a father yourself, like how far are you able to relate to Ned's situation in the film?
It was very close to me. You know, to be able to step into those shoes was very comfortable. I have a 23-year-old daughter. I'm of that age, you know, when you're watching them hang around with other people and it's getting serious and it's not, you know. So it wasn't difficult for me to slip into Ned's shoes. And I really related to what a lot of people go through is hanging on to relevance, you know, that I think Ned is afraid. I think he was afraid that he's losing his daughter's affections and she's not going to need him anymore. The business has surpassed him. He's in a business that is outdated. So he's outdated and unimportant too. So I think he's scrambling. He's nervous. And in typical male fashion, he's not going to tell anybody about it. Fine, everything's good. We got it under control. That's so male to go into our little cave and I'll take care of it. I'll handle this. And yet realize that you can't handle it and you do need some help.
And James, I love Led's kind of childlike honesty and the fact he has no filter, very endearing. What did you like about him and in what ways did you identify with him?
He does have great curiosity. He's not afraid to, you know, try things, do what he wants. And I love that he's in love. He's truly in love. I find that very endearing, and that he wants to change. Maybe he doesn't know that he needs to change, but he comes to realize that, and he's willing. I love that. I think that's beautiful.
And there's always a lot of pressure when you want to impress someone, and you know the build up to that meeting, especially if it's a potential in-law. I just wondered if there is a time when either of you have sort of made a huge blunder or just sort of made a bad impression in front of people you were desperately kind of trying to impress.
I think I said to a date's dad once, "I'll have her back at midnight after I hang her on the couch." I think I said that once. That was a mistake. I should have said around the bed. I guess I didn't know the couch was off limits or something.
James, how about you?
You can tell it's near the end of the day. You give an answer like that.
I don't know. Can't really beat that.
It's hard to tell.
But let's say, for instance, that might have been clipped out. What would happen then?
So, exactly. You guys have spent quite a lot of time together now. And Bryan, hypothetically, what would you make of James as the potential son-in-law?
You know, aside from the fact that he's way too old for my daughter, if that wasn't the case, I think you are, right? But I would want someone. I've come to know James, and he's a good man. And that's what you need. I want someone who is going to be kind and decent and honest. And that's all you. I don't go too deep. Is kind, decent, honest. Do you love him? Does he love you? That's good. I'm good. If I can just get that, then I'm fine. And if it was James Franco, so much the better.
And James,
he's rich. He's rich too. That'd be good. He could take care of me in my old age.
And how about you? How about if Bryan was a potential father-in-law?
The best. Ride motorcycles together.
Yeah, man.
What else we do together?
We ride motorcycles together.
Mountain climb. just do every movie together. Just be great.